Good day everyone. I'm going to tell you a little bit more about the Dahlia breeding and the selection process here that we have at Malanseuns. So we're sitting here in a field of over 1,000 new Dahlia varieties. That's never seen before. It was crossings that we made last year in 2023, and this was all seedlings planted out in January, and it's flowering now. So it's flowering for the very, very first time. So I'm going to tell you a little bit more on how do we do selections. So there's a few different Dahlia types and there's a few different Dahlia shapes. So in this one in front of me, you can see it's a nice pinkish one. Then we have a Dahlia that is a nice compact flowering one and is not showing the inside. This means this flower is going to last much longer on the plant and also in the vase. Whereas this one that is completely showing his inside is not going to last so long because it wants to produce seed and everything so much quicker. So that is one of the selections that we see. Okay, there's a different type. This one is almost looking like a cosmos type of Dahlia, where this one is that really nice old Dahlia favorite one that we all know in our grandmother's garden. Then, so we at Malanseuns, there's a few selections that we're doing. So Dahlias is all, the old varieties is all long varieties that you need to stake in your garden. So when the wind is coming or whatever, then the Dahlias is flopping over. We as Malanseuns, we're producing good varieties for the garden that's giving garden pleasure. So that means you don't need to stake them. It's just, and that's what we test here. So you can see none of them has been sprayed anything. It's just like we test them. So then we go and we see, okay, disease resistant. Is there any Dahlias that gets a lot of mildew? So mildew is a big disease in Dahlias. And when you walk through here, you will see there's almost no Dahlias with mildew. So we call them, it's much more mildew resistant. And that gives you much, much more gardening pleasure at the end of the day. So you don't need to spray them. Then the next thing we're looking at is a nice compact variety that's not too tall. So when the wind is blowing or too much rain, it's not flopping over. And then we look for the amount of buds. Because at the end of the day, we all have a garden to have as many flowers and as long as possible. So we see how much buds is there per plant. And then we also go and we look for the colors. So at the end of the day, our end consumers must buy the plant. So we must go for the fashionable colors. And that's where you come in. So you have to help us as Malanseuns to decide which is our 20 best plants. So it's really difficult because if you look long enough, everyone is really unique and very special in each and every way. So that's the reasons we're doing, and then also disease resistance. So you'll see in this field, there's quite a lot of Dahlias that got Ervinia. Ervinia is a root disease, and of that ones we just keep them, so we let them die because it shows to us that those plants is not disease resistant towards Ervinia. So all of these plants that's still going strong, all of them are disease resistant and resistant to Ervinia. So it will give you so much garden pleasure and so much garden fun. If you have any questions, please just comment below and we'll get back to you. But this is the Malanseuns Dahlias.